to the Banger Elks Halloween Parade as we're getting ready to continue to celebrate the 2017 Halloween season here on Service Electric TV2 Sports. Along with Megan Caffrey, I am Doug Heater, and welcome once again to our Halloween coverage. Megan and I have never done a Halloween parade together, so we're kind of excited to see how this is going to go. And really great crowd and a turnout so far. A lot of people dressed up here in the town of Banger.
And this is actually my first ever Halloween parade that I'm doing too, so it's brand new to me. It's really exciting, and it is. The streets are filled up. I was not expecting this at all.
Well, of course, the obligatory "yes, I didn't wear my costume" joke get out of the way. But obviously, a lot of the fans turning out here tonight did indeed dress up their kids or even the adults with a different costume. So, of course, candy being handed out, and we're taking a look at the Banger Elks Lodge, 1106, and they're heading away down Market Street, I believe we are here in Banger, and a great turnout. I know this parade. It's a great bang for your buck, so to speak. It's a tight window these guys are navigating, and the crowd is all over the place here enjoying it tonight.
Now, with everyone throwing out the candy, if you had a type of candy to choose to get, what's your favorite candy?
Three Musketeers, always.
Ooh.
Ever. Always, since I was little, absolutely. Now, of course, I don't eat that kind of stuff anymore. But that was easily my favorite. How about you?
Reese's, definitely. I'm Reese's through and through. My favorite ice cream, then, is chocolate peanut butter, too, so you gotta get a little bit of this. Look at that, even his glasses lit up.
So they're firing some here that we might get an opportunity to receive here. That's the Pennsylvania Elks Awareness Program heading by. Now, if you ask me what kind of car I'd like to drive, it'd probably be this Hummer coming our way.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, that's for now, all right? I'm going to shout that out right now.
Are you going to go off-roading in that? Or
absolutely.
You have to do something.
You drove your way up here, right? You know what? There's a lot of places to four-wheel going up through Banger here. There's no question about it.
There definitely is. You would have a lot of fun. Probably gas isn't the best with that car.
The mileage. Joe Capozzola, who's the mayor here. Yeah, we'll take some.
Here we go.
Absolutely. Yeah, Megan caught the lollipop. All right.
Cherry. Do you like cherry?
Well, we'll,
I like
we'll save that for.
If we're doing the Jolly Ranchers, watermelon.
Yeah, I don't know, but I'll go to cherry one over. Watermelon, that's.
Pushing it.
The actual real watermelon, yes. But as far as candy goes, I don't know so much about that.
Very fair.
County Executive Joe Brown coming your way now.
Look at that.
Take a look at the Alpha Romeo.
And it kind of looks like their outfits literally, they look like Marilyn Monroe kind of on the side here, right?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah.
Oh.
I'm going to get some. Thank you
for
Marilyn and Tootsie Rolls. Nice.
Yes.
We're doing well here. Reese's. Oh, no, wait.
Reese's Pieces.
I'm handing it to Megan.
It's even better because sometimes there's a ton of them.
And the hometown Banger Slater marching band all decked out. I passed some of these guys coming in. Incredible Hulk is in there.
Oh,
Batman,
wow.
Of course.
Now, do you have any idea what song they're playing? I can never tell with marching band what song they're
end of this band all dressed as candy. It's interesting. Some Twizzlers.
I like the Jelly Belly costume that came by. One of my friends one year dressed up as a grape, and it was kind of the same thing where they had all of the purple balloons on them.
Well, my sister did that one year at my Halloween party, and of course we decided popping them would be interesting after a while. So, that's a good call. Banger Slater cheerleaders, of course, following the marching band.
They're all Dalmatians.
This is an easy one to figure out,
That was my favorite Disney movie growing up, the 101 Dalmatians. I loved that movie.
I liked Robin Hood. That's an oldie. Robin Hood was my favorite.
I remember that movie that came out, though. It was Robin Hood, Man in Tights, Men in Tights.
Yeah.
Did you ever see that one?
Are you ready? Are you ready? Tonight,
cheerleaders are always awesome to watch, especially when they're doing those stunts. My sister was a cheerleader in high school, and she's tiny. She's a lot smaller than I am, and so she was the girl that got thrown up and did all the flips. And my mom would sit there on Friday nights in the stands watching, scared for her life if Caitlin was going to get injured or not.
I can imagine. Now, there's some frights coming our way here. Here we go. Scariest. Oh, yeah, that's the scariest.
Oh, man.
He's eyeing up Megan there for a minute. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
That's a good one.
Look at that.
That's a good one.
That's a good one. That's a scary one. It's like a haunted hayride.
So this is the Slate Belt Y leading the way here with a farm tractor.
Oh, and Charlotte's Web.
Yeah, nice. Oh, and we have a live pig in there.
Oh, my gosh.
Nice.
There we go.
You know, I hear they make really, no joke, great pets.
I know a lot of people have those, like, miniature or toy pigs, I guess is what it is. Stinky kind of pet, right?
Well, they claim they're very clean, and I, again, am being serious here, yes.
Oh.
For a pig, you wouldn't think that, being it's a pig, but
yeah.
We'll have to look into that. But the Slate Belt Y doing a nice job on that particular float. And here comes Pack 102, of course, the Cub Scout Pack, located right here in Bangor, Pennsylvania.
Were you a Cub Scout or a Boy Scout first,
I
right?
I was a Cub Scout for a while, and then they moved to Weeblos, and then it's kind of dropped off. Well, a sad story, the lady that was our den leader couldn't do it anymore, and we really enjoyed it, so we kind of all... My son did it for a while, almost got up to Eagle Scout, but
really?
Yeah.
That all amazed
great,
me.
It's a great opportunity for the boys, no question.
I never made it to, on the girl side things, I never made it to Girl Scout. I think we started off as a sunflower and then a brown.
Yep.
And I never made past browning. That's as far as
well, if there's a Girl Scout troop coming, we'll have to take a look. Oh, there is. Coming up in a little bit. Maybe you can, you know, finish that. It's like going back to college, right?
Oh, all the memories come back.
Finish it up, right?
Yeah, I can ask them if I can join. I still have my vest somewhere, right?
So, again, this is Pack 102. They got a couple of little
So they had a Star Wars theme a little bit, kind of, right?
Yeah, oh, yeah. Got some stormtroopers in there waving our way.
Yep. Look at that. Are you a big Star Wars fan?
I wouldn't say big. I would say fan.
Okay.
So,
we'll
you know,
that.
Kind of. Now, of course, those originals that came out were when I was 10 or 12, and they were great. Now it's just too much. What's the word? Like, well, those were all real. Like, they were mine. That was neat. This is, so I still enjoy it, but it's not like I'm dying to go see the new one. I do, however, have plans.
Did you see that new one?
The new one, I guess, is there a new one coming out soon that I have plans to see?
The one that, the most previous
no,
one that
have
came
not.
Out, I did not see that
no.
one either. My one friend saw it three times. I think it was a pretty long movie, so I was like, that is a very true avid fan.
I do know what a stormtrooper is, so I did notice a couple there. So this is the Prince of Peace float, which is a little Noah's Ark theme. Very nice.
Nice.
Very nice, yes.
We've got two of every each animal,
yep.
right? Two
flies.
Oh. And we have a bumblebee. This is another bird. The learning locomotion is making their way down next. They have balloons.
I know if they're handing them out, you want one of those for sure.
Oh, yeah. So there's a little bit of everything in this one.
Yes.
They're just dressed up real nice.
Well, I'm guessing Wizard of Oz theme, right? There's Dorothy. Scarecrow, yeah.
And then...
Well, there's a werewolf in the back end here.
Isn't a werewolf part of that story?
No, it's
no,
a lion.
Oh, yes.
I'm going to let that one go. Megan, you thought
I'm
a werewolf was in Wizard of Oz.
My stories are all messed up. I'm thinking of the Huff and Puff and Blow Your House Down.
And Captain Underpants, which is in the back end, also was not in the Wizard of Oz.
No,
all right?
Not at all. Oh, but look here. Look, oh, there's more superheroes that we have coming up, right? There we have, right there. Look at that. What was your favorite Halloween costume when you were little? So we have our different stages of Halloween costumes. When you were about this age, she's got some great curls.
All right, Spider-Man.
Ooh.
So this is going to take a while to tell this story,
okay.
So I have to make sure I don't miss anybody.
Okay.
So I'll tell you this, Spider-Man had to have it when I was a kid. But I actually thought when my mom bought me the costume that I was going to be able to shoot webs. No joke.
Oh, man.
I opened it out of the box. I'm like, what's the, there's no, I could not wait to be climbing in my room on my spider webs.
Look at this, a Cadillac.
This from Nick Ronco Motors, located here in East Bangor. A little 70s theme it looks
yeah.
like right here.
Those sunglasses are coming back in style.
Now here, I guess they are. here comes the Girl Scout troop. So
here
what's, all right, so you got mine. I just told you a funny story about Spider-Man. I thought I could climb it. How about you?
My mom was very, when we were younger, my mom would make all of our costumes. She's very crafty, very creative. She would make all of them. And so, one year, my sister, the year before, she was a cat. And so it was like this whole entire suit. And the year after, I really wanted to be a bat. So my mom flipped the costume around, gave me wings.
Yeah.
And I think I liked it the most because it was the warmest costume I ever had. And it was a really cold Halloween that year.
Yeah, that works. By the way, every girl at some point in her life is a cat.
Oh, yes. Everyone's that at some point.
So this is the Girl Scout Troop 887. Megan's going to, she's
yeah.
taking down the number. She's going to fill it out to see if she can finish her
time. They had
her
popcorn
time.
In the
yeah,
back of that, if you guys saw that. Popcorn is my favorite snack. So they, I'm just going to, maybe I would have to take off my headset and go pop on that float, finish it off with them.
Now, as an adult, I went to multiple parties as Paul Stanley from Kiss.
Oh.
That was my favorite. That happened more than once, yeah.
That, do you have any photos of that?
Oh, there are.
We will have
You will
to.
Not be seeing those.
We might have to have a
yes.
resurface at some point.
Actually, another, yeah. I also went as the Frankenfurter from Rocky Horror Picture Show. Those photos will never be seen.
That's
that was a good
great
one.
Costume.
Yeah, that was interesting. This is Tolino's Winery. They were the nice float. Handing out some goodies to the kids.
Oh, yeah. Look at this, a little tropical theme.
Yeah. Sweet tarts, I think they're firing out here.
No one's throwing us any candy.
No, we're not the little kids. We're too old. Oh,
yeah.
So I got one.
Oh,
right
you
here.
Got one.
Well, I didn't know it, but it's somewhere.
We'll see. Ooh, now what do we have right here? Look at this, the Minion. There's a. Oh.
This is Derek Spence leading the way here. But this is with some minions. Oh, all kinds of inflatables, yep.
Lots of that. I love minions.
And this is the Bangor Drive-In.
Dogs in there. They've got two puppies.
Wow.
Oh, look at these dance moves. Ooh.
That, Michael Jackson, yeah.
Yeah.
And Ricky Reed here following up in his car, the Maximum Destruction car.
Ooh. Now those are some wheels to have, right?
Now this should be the Penn Argyle High School marching band.
Recognize that song.
And I think their band director was the cutout mask that they had. He was dressed as Waldo, if you saw him go by.
Oh,
pretty sure.
I did not notice that.
AAA Northampton County following up the Bangor's cheerleaders and the Bangor marching band.
Wow, they're taking out candy. Right. I wonder if they have a lot of candy in there or if it's just disguise. Got a wagon full of candy.
Yeah. So this is Cub Scout Pack 14, located nearby in Richmond, PA.
tons of minions here.
Yeah.
This is always fun, group costumes. So with all of your costumes throughout the years, have you ever been in a group costume?
So, like, connected?
Yeah, like everyone did a little something either.
Sort of. I was the television, and someone else was the remote control, but we were not adjoined,
okay,
so to speak. So, no, I've never done the whole, like, horse thing, right? Is it, you're, you know.
Yeah.
No.
Oh, I've seen some.
I'm sorry, when I was little, when I was little with my sister, we were Siamese twins. Yes.
Wow.
Yeah, that was very difficult to walk.
Yeah.
I'm going to say I was about probably 10, maybe 8 when we did that. Yeah, ooh. So I did. How about you?
We did a couple of, like, group Halloween costumes in college, but in high school I was an Avatar one year. When, after that movie had come out.
Oh, yeah.
A couple of friends and I were Avatars. That was cool. We painted ourselves blue and got wigs and those colored contacts. That was a cool one.
Nice. That's a good one, yeah. So, country carpets, floors and more coming by.
Oh, look at this, a scarecrow. Have you ever seen those videos on YouTube of the pranksters on Halloween,
yeah,
dressed up as the scarecrow holding the bucket of candy? Yep. Someone comes, it's a real person.
Yeah, I did that last year, actually.
No
handing
way.
Out. Well, I wasn't a scarecrow. I was dressed up just in a mask and in costume and in my front porch, and kids were sure if it was real or not. They didn't get as many people up to the door as I expected.
Yeah.
A little fright there, but yes.
But I love all that spooky stuff with Halloween. I did the Eastern State Penitentiary one year with my friends.
Oh, yeah,
that's
yeah.
That's fun to do.
Yeah, I actually went up to that near Hackettstown this past weekend to a farm to do the hayride haunted house.
Was it good? Was it scary or
was it
contained?
Well, you know what? There's a fine line between too intense and not enough. It was in the middle there, but, you know, the haunted house was very nicely done. I don't know. So you're from New Jersey. There's a place up here at Sailorsburg, the Lake House, which is located right off of 33. Good. It's a haunted. It's a hotel.
Ooh.
Hotel of Horrors. Try that out. It's good. It's a good deal. Yeah.
That's something I'm going to put that on my list to do.
So this is the Shriners Tin Lizzies, as you can see. Anybody watching that hasn't been there either, too, is good. But that was a very... Oh, so you're familiar with Clinton, New Jersey, right?
Yes,
the mill?
I am.
If they still do the haunted house there, you got to try that one.
I've never been to it.
That's
I know
really
a ton of
good.
People went to it. They have to still do it. I've been on a haunted hayride close to me. That was very... It wasn't that scary, but it was still fun.
That is outstanding. Yeah. I wouldn't mind putting those on a track and racing them around.
That would be fun. Now, for little cars, those really are loud.
They're moving pretty good, too.
Yeah, they have some speed behind them. You did in the summer. You did a go-kart.
At the Steel Stacks and all that for the Arts Quest at the Grand Prix. That was fun. I didn't expect when I got there that day to race. That was fun. I'm ready for next year, though.
Wow, so you went in totally unexpected.
No.
How did you finish that day?
Not good. Our guys, none of us knew. Now we got a strategy now. Believe me, I've already been mentally and physically preparing for that one, if you can do that. So Forks of the Delaware Shrine Club going by here, following the Shriners. That holds all the cars right there.
Wow, yeah. Well, I guess for little cars, all of them can
all
fit
in there, yeah. You fit a full-size race car in that
one. I did my first NASCAR this summer, and those trucks that they transport the race cars, and those are
huge. Oh, you're up at Pocono, right?
Yep,
yeah.
Pocono.
Oh, so I did a couple laps around there in the fall. My mom got it for me for my birthday.
That
was
is
cool.
A present to ask for.
Yeah, that was neat. Grace on Broadway going by here. Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Another
a
lollipop.
Tootsie Pop.
Oh wait, some more here. Oh, there you go.
Oh, we got lots of Tootsie Rolls.
We got another one coming.
Ooh.
Oh, right in the bread basket there. Yeah, all right.
Oh, my God.
The kids in front of us are getting tons of
fun.
It's fun. It's exciting. And then at the end of the night, when you're trick-or-treating especially, you dump it out. You count the pieces. You say what you got. And then you trade sometimes. So if you want your Three Musketeers,
Were you ever, I was taught as a kid to savor my candy. In fact, I made it to Thanksgiving once. Were you one of those that ripped into it and were done by the 2 days later, or were you
I was a candy hoarder, I'd like to say. I would call myself a candy hoarder, I think it's safe to say. But there's also a strategy to it, and I'm more of a chocolate person.
Okay.
But you have to separate your candy,
too. Oh, yeah.
Because if you keep the chocolate with, like, all the sweets and the Sour Patch Kids and stuff, the chocolate doesn't taste as good.
Yeah, I know what you're saying, yeah.
And then you freeze the chocolate, though. So my story is sometimes I would have them at Christmas time, I'd realize, I forgot that this was in the freezer.
Well done. I used to freeze my Easter Bunny with chocolate rabbits. That's gold. Now, you like Reese's. You know what you do? You crack the head off and you stick peanut butter down in there.
Never done that before.
There you go.
That's my new thing.
Right?
On that note, though, the Reese's eggs, they need to do like a Reese's pumpkin for Halloween. That's essentially the same concept as the egg.
Oh, yeah, that's a good call, yeah.
Because it's just, there's something about the peanut butter to chocolate ratio on those that are so good.
Merchants Bank coming by. So some tips on how to eat your chocolate bunny in Easter. And Megan thinks Reese's should make a pumpkin egg, which is a good call.
You heard it here first on Service Electric.
That is a good call.
Get this more popcorn.
So this is obviously, if you haven't figured out, this is kind of a movie character theme parade. So that's why you see a lot of movie floats and we see a lot of characters from movies. We haven't seen a Freddy Krueger yet, which I'm interested. I guess everybody's is being a little bit more. Oh, there we go. As I say that, look at that. Literally did not see them, and there they go.
There.
Right
and
by.
More minions. Tons of minions today.
Another Cub Scout pack. About ready to come down the street here from Rosetto, which is just up the hill here from where we are.
And you know what the fun thing about this too is? We're seeing a lot of really nice pickup trucks.
Yeah.
Lots of good pickup trucks. And my little brother has a pickup truck. He loves pickup trucks. He would be going nuts at this parade just because of pickup trucks.
Ooh, okay. This is a nice one here. A lot of superheroes loaded up in there.
Nice.
Duck for cover here.
Oh, they've got another
one. There it comes. There it is. You guys
nice
catch.
Look at this. Starburst.
Wow. Another one. Oh, yeah. Oh, boy.
I got a duck. Right at us.
Man. Yep. Could be Beetlejuice over there. Could be. I'm not sure.
Beetlejuice.
Nope, the cheerleaders. The youth football team and cheerleaders here in front of us. These guys were gearing up before where I was parking to get ready for the parade.
They are awesome.
Oh, wait, we're getting something to deliver here. Look at this.
Right to the table.
Two lollipops.
Thank
oh,
so
thanks.
Much.
Wow.
Well,
he evened that out pretty nicely, yes.
Yeah. Well, look at this, some flips right here. Wow. I lost count how many he was doing.
Perform for us. Look at
I like that little cheer that they have going on there. Like I said earlier, my sister was a cheerleader. I was always jealous of her. She did the whole through Pop Warner. I guess this isn't Pop Warner just yet.
Well, close to that,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. But she did the Pop Warner and everything.
Yeah. Here comes more football players. Yeah. So when I coached over at Forks, these guys were the Blue Valley Patriots. So it looks like the Slaters now have their own colors and everything, Youth Football League. Nice.
Yeah. It's always fun for all of them. And you think so many of them probably have older brothers and sisters who are football players and cheerleaders at the high school.
Well, this is a good-sized organization. Nice, yeah.
Tons of them.
Megan's trying to get more goodies.
They kind of look at me and just wave, and I'm like, but I want
it. Here we go. There we go. Thanks.
You.
There you go.
Yeah.
Awesome. Laffy Taffy thrown in there.
Laffy Taffy.
All right, so this is, well, Zombie Float's coming, but it looks like a group of minions going to perform here first. And then they got a Zombie Float with a Fogger. So I have one of those in my house.
You have to be a haunted house.
So, well, we have it. I have a nice coffin I built out front. So my wife, Angela, got this for us last year, thinking that, yeah, we'd use it outside. Nope. Fire that, like, just all throughout the day. I had that out on October 1st, but there's a Fogger coming your way. So I have one of those. Got to put it in the house. And just.
You need to have, like, either a Halloween party or something with that. You love Halloween,
yes.
I'm assuming, from your
yes.
past costumes and everything. Halloween, I love Halloween. It's one of those that, well, I was in the mall earlier today. Christmas decorations up already.
Yeah, too soon.
Too soon.
Yeah.
I was like, Halloween hasn't happened yet. Thanksgiving is my favorite holiday by far. I love Thanksgiving.
That is good. So here's the Zombie Float coming with the Fogger in there. That's nice, nicely done.
This is awesome.
Yep.
Oh, look at this mask. See, now this is something that, this is like a haunted hayride. This is like the podcast I was telling you I was listening to. This person is creepy enough for Halloween. This is the creepiness. Now look at this girl on the back.
Yeah, hanging off the end. This is some good makeup there,
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we do.
Whoa. To a chiropractor before.
They work.
They do.
Yep. I will say I was not a true believer, but they work.
But what I've always heard about them is once you go there, you always have to go back very consistently.
Fix me up, we're good to go.
Okay. Now, you've sold me on that. So what do we have coming up here?
So more Girl Scouts. This is the Slate Belt Girl Scouts coming.
And more popcorn.
Looks like it, yeah.
So, Girl Scout cookies, what's your favorite?
The Thin Mints.
Yes.
Now,
freeze those.
Well,
those are
right.
Good.
Oh, that's where you store them. that's where they stay. So, what is it? The s'mores? Is that the new one that came out? Like, I think
they
this past.
S'mores?
Yeah, and they literally couldn't. I did an interview with a lady that was from a Girl Scout troop for one of our Phantoms intermissions, and they can't keep them. They didn't have enough of them.
They're the hot sellers.
Yeah, they just didn't have enough of them, yeah.
No, I think the Samoas are the coconut kind of ones.
Yeah, they're good, yeah.
And the original ones, the short, I know that the names keep changing, so I think they were originally called shortbread and now they have a different name. The ones that come in the blue box, that's all I remember.
Yes.
Those. So you can tell that I ended my career relatively
just
early.
Fill out the sheet when they come to your house. I'll take the blue box ones.
But the fun thing is, and I don't know if they still do it, I remember it's all about the prize. The more cookies you sell, you get something really cool.
Yep.
I wonder what prizes they give now.
Oh, they're pretty good if you put those away, yes.
Ooh, look at this cotton candy.
Yeah, nice. That's a good one.
That's a good one.
Yeah. That might be a quesadilla box.
Ooh, a quesadilla box. Oh, here we
Twix.
Go.
Oh, thank you.
Oh,
yeah,
nachos.
She handed it to me
nachos.
Right there. Yes. Mm. Yeah, it's. Oh, yes, I should have known that was nacho, not a quesadilla. That was way too fancy.
And look at that. Look at this little. Oh, she just walked off. She'll come back in. This little witch, she has a nose, too.
Yeah.
There she is.
So now Cub Scout Pack 41 from Johnsonville.
Oh,
is this the Up House?
I think it is.
That movie's pretty good.
That's a great movie.
My favorite character is the dog.
Yes. You would love the dog.
Oh, it's great.
This is once it comes closer, this is a great float.
Yeah, so the dog's name is Doug, right? That's not why, but I do. There, our guys are told, reminded me, yes.
But he's funny, he's a little sarcastic.
Well, yes, he is. Oh, that's hilarious, yep. And now to me, every dog talks like that, so it's fun, yes.
Do you have a dog?
Yes.
Ooh, look
it is a Weimaraner Pit Bull Great Dane mix.
Wow.
It's something.
So that's a bigger dog.
Pretty good size, yeah. It's like Scooby-Doo, but thinner.
Ooh.
Like that size.
That's
the head's
a great
not as big.
Comparison.
But yeah, that's about it, the best way to describe
that's
it.
One thing, that's a great group costume. Scooby-Doo, everyone from
yeah,
there.
Yeah, that's a good
a great
call, yeah.
Costume.
Yep.
Look at this little house.
Yeah, it's the up house, yep.
They did a great job on that.
Because that's right, the boy was a...
A Boy Scout.
Yeah, well, he was, they had a special name for them because it...
Oh, because they couldn't, in the movie, they couldn't take him.
Because he had the hat and everything, nicely done.
Good job. There wasn't a dog there.
But they stopped a little bit too far down the street here. These guys are still playing. Nice job.
Great job by them.
Jeep here going by.
Look at this.
All right, so now this is Student Transportation of America coming up. So the Minions don't only associate with despicable people, they mainly wish to be friendly and kind to everyone, and we stress a bully-free school and bus ride. This is what we do at STA and Minion Academy, try to encourage with all our students. So a real nice message here by the Student Transportation of America.
That really is, especially on buses. I took buses my whole entire life growing up, and I mean, bullying can happen on buses, but at the same time, they're so much fun because you get to make friends with all your neighborhood kids.
So the Minions leading the way, and they've even got their school bus decorated here.
Yeah. Were you a busser to school, or did you walk?
Yes, no, bus for a while until I could drive.
Yeah.
And then actually, I walked a little bit. I could get dropped off and walk, and then people used to give me rides. But yeah, so I always did the same thing. It was usually where I was, we would interrupt the back end of it, or I had the longest ride.
Yep.
It was one or the other. I wasn't in the middle of the bus route.
No happy medium for you.
No. Nice job decorating the bus there.
Oh, yeah. Now we have the Easy Rider motorcycle coming up.
Yep. See, they know where to stop, right in the light.
Vroom, vroom. Have you gone through a motorcycle phase? Have you ever wanted?
I had one for a while, yeah.
What kind of motorcycle did you have?
It was, oh man, it's been a while. So I had a Honda way back in the day, and then I had a Kawasaki that was a Nighthawk. I'm still going back a ways, yeah. is Ravenold Productions.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. I think you just got a wink there. That reminds me, see that with the singing and everything, that reminds me of the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
Yeah.
Those are always...
Now this is where, so this is what you were talking about earlier, that if that was a real person that could just all of a sudden start moving, that would freak some people out. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Oh yeah.
And so Ravenold Productions doing a good job with that asylum. No Suicide Squad. That was that movie, right?
Yes.
Yeah. No Suicide Squad people yet. Nothing. That was interesting. Yeah.
Nothing there. There's another very common costume. Scream. Is Scream not a thing anymore for kids to dress up?
I think that's kind of beyond. Yeah. That was really freaky there for a while.
That everyone wanted to be Scream.
Yes.
You'd have tons of them. I don't even know what the newest scary movie kind of costumes are that people have. I don't know.
Yeah, that's true. That's...
I'll try and...
So... This is Welcome to the Land of Oz coming. So now we'll see if there's a wolf man in this one.
We'll see. You never know.
This is, we believe, Rebels Elite Cheerleading Float coming around the corner with the Wizard of Oz theme.
The Land of Oz. They have the yellow brick.
Yep.
Have you ever, are you a big Broadway show kind of guy?
Not really, no.
Okay, because I was going to say, the Broadway show that's now escaping my head, that is the Wizard of Oz theme.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. Yeah.
Is so good, and I recommend anyone to see it if I could remember the name of that. Wicked. There we go.
Yeah. Too much sports for me to distract myself with going to see
true.
A Broadway show.
Yes, and that needs to become a day, so you need a day off for that. They have the Wizard of Oz music.
It's a nice float they did. Float flying monkeys, they were the scariest part of that movie.
Oh, yeah. Ow.
And I believe these are the cheerleaders with Rebels Elite.
Yeah.
They might put
and
on a little performance coming, I think. Maybe.
So we've got the lion, the Tin Man, and there's a scarecrow. Dorothy's down. All the girls with the blue skirts are Dorothy. Look at the little Tin Man costumes. Those are cute. Let's see what they're gonna do.
Yeah.
Rebels Elite cheerleaders performing for us.
In the Wizard of Oz costumes with no wolf.
No, because apparently there's a wolf in that movie.
No, we haven't seen so far yet? Disney princesses.
Yeah, that's odd, because that's a big theme. Yeah, Frozen,
there was one Elsa, I believe, yes, that walked by. She walked by a little bit earlier, but no Cinderella's, Snow White. That's a good group costume, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
Yeah.
What dwarf would you be?
Oh, come on. Dopey. I have to be dopey, right?
I think I might want to be sleepy.
If we did that for work, Gwen could be sneezy.
Yeah, that's... Yeah.
A little inside joke there between the two of us. Yeah, she could be sneezy. We'll have to mention that to her. Joe Emmerich, state representative, with his Jeep.
Nice green Jeep. I've always had basic color cars. Well, always, and I mean the one car that I have.
So that would be white, yeah, that one. So one always, car. That always.
But I guess my fam growing up, the family car. This is Lukey's Fall Festival. Wow, bike tricks back here. I'd love to see, so from covering all of the Velodrome this summer, I'd love to see if any of those cyclists could do stuff like that.
Yeah, I don't know.
I think they just like the circles, to just go around circles. They'll steer clear of this.
Yes.
Mr. Miss Potato
Head. Potato Head, yes.
Oh, so this is, because I see Buzz and Woody down there. This is a little Toy Story.
Yeah.
Love that. Are one of them Slinky? Toy Story 3 was so sad how they just had to end it.
I can't remember the third one, but...
Andy goes to college.
Well, that's right, yeah. So I guess you have to at some point, right?
Yeah, you have to grow up.
Hope Springs Community of Faith coming your way next. Ghostbusters on the trailer there.
Oh, and he's singing too. It's a good voice. What a movie. I never saw the newer Ghostbusters.
All right, so the Ghostbusters back in the day, classic.
Yes.
Classic. So I did not want to see the newer one because I thought it was going to ruin me. But actually, it was pretty funny.
I will say
that was pretty good, yeah.
Because
usually, like the second ones come out and they tried to redo Roadhouse, which to me is a classic movie too. But anyhow, so when they did Ghostbusters, I'm like, I don't want to see it. It was pretty good. Yeah, the first one.
I remember when the newer one was coming out, there was a ton of back and forth with that. Do we see the new one?
Yeah.
Because the original one was just so good. I still haven't seen the newer one just because I just never got around to it.
What was cool about it good. It was funny. And they had each one of the original characters at some point make an appearance in the movie, not as themselves, but as a different. It was good.
Done.
Yeah. Take it back, man, yo. DJ Smith with a Z at the end. The old party animal says here on the side of his truck.
Hands on your knees. Can't fuck with it. And this is a good song for the party. Yeah.
It's like a slumber party theme up there. Cha cha now, yo.
Turn it up. To the left.
song everyone loved at school dances when I was growing
up. Oh, yeah.
That and Cotton Eye Joe.
Every night at Iron Pigs, you hear that.
Really?
They play it after the seventh inning stretch, yeah. It's like a baseball tradition at some places, but it was the electric slide was big for a while there, too. Right?
Those are all fun, like, wedding songs,
to
get everyone out on the dance floor, because then grandma knows it, and she can do it a little bit with her cane.
Looks like the Slate Belt Nursing and Rehab Center is coming up next.
And I think do we have more minions up there? It's fun to see when you have multiples of a certain costume. Everyone does it differently.
Yeah.
Everyone has their own take on it. They get creative with it, and that's really fun. So Minions and Dalmatians, both?
Yeah.
I was a Dalmatian 1 year. Oh,
Tootsie Roll, a little short. There we go.
Oh.
A couple coming in. Boy, it's like taking on.
Literally, you need a little bit of a shield.
They're
like
all
a
over
bucket
the ground here, yes. I need a net next time.
We could be fishermen.
Smokey the Bear.
Never seen a Smokey the Bear costume before.
You know what? Other than maybe at an event where Smokey the Bear was supposed to appear, you're right. That's true.
Yeah.
Plainfield Township Fire Department.
We're going to Christmas again, but I remember when I was little, a couple of years they would have Santa Claus on a fire truck that would come around the neighborhood and hand out candy canes.
Yep.
They don't do that all.
Where I live, that still happens.
Oh,
yeah, they do.
Fun.
Yep. Yep. And the kids know it's coming. It's like the ice cream truck.
Yes. Oh. I think my neighborhood now, we're all just grown, so they've moved on to different neighborhoods, and that makes me so upset. I would still go out for the ice cream truck. Get me a Chipwich.
This is Regal Dodge. We have a Kona Ice that even comes by, so I think Wind Gap Chevy is next. Lightning McQueen, right?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, this is still a Dodge. I've got the front cover. That's my apology, yes. That's the Viper. Yeah, I should have known that.
Ooh. Oh, look, and I don't know, what was this one's name? I couldn't tell you.
So I knew Lightning, and then the
Rusty
tow truck.
Was the truck, right? Rusty
the tow truck, yeah. I'm not. Also a good movie, but I can't name all the characters.
I
think there is actually a Rusty coming, too.
Oh, yeah.
Nice job with this.
And they even have their own people taking photos from up there. That's one of my favorite country songs. Miss Fritter coming up here.
Oh, yeah, now the guys in the truck are looking up the names for us. Thanks, though.
That helps.
Oh, okay. No, they claim they've watched it, so okay. I can't remember all the characters. I didn't want to ignore the comment about the country song. I don't know what that.
Oh,
I
you're not a country fan.
I like all music. I just don't know the song, the country song
okay.
as well.
That was a Rascal Flatts.
I mean, other than Hank Williams Jr. outside of that, and
okay.
you know, yeah.
Ooh, now the kids are throwing candy back.
The bus is decorated nicely too.
Yeah.
You get wheel covers like that for my truck.
That would be a fun Halloween thing, a haunted bus with a story behind
yeah.
there. All right, now, I'm waiting for the boys in the truck to help us now. I don't know these two.
I just think this is, yeah. yeah, they're enjoying themselves, yes. The rusty one was pretty cool. That looked
yeah,
authentic.
That really did it.
Regal Dodge is about half the parade here. They had a
whole
bunch of cars and trucks in this one.
Now a Dodge. Is that Batman on the side?
That's Batman in the back, I think, too.
Yeah. Like he could use that as a racing helmet too.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
He could go hang out with all the motorcycle guys with his Batman motorcycle helmet. Is this the last of our Dodge?
Now Wind Gap Chevy follows Regal Dodge. It's a tough act to follow.
Yeah. Now, with all the driving I do, before I started listening to the podcast, because I'm now a podcast fanatic, I always listen to the radio, and Wind Gap Chevy always has great commercials on the radio. I'd hear them a lot on my drive to work. Are these the men in black?
I believe so, yes.
See, the thing is now, like, all these little kids, do the little kids know what the Men in Black are?
Well, I think so.
Do they still see those movies?
I think so.
They're giving out koozies instead of candy.
I don't know what you'd use one of those for, but I'll take one over here.
Yeah. Kids going in the street in front of the cars. Or is that someone part of the float?
I hope so.
I would hope so too.
So I think this is the East Bangor Volunteer Fire Company, and they're promoting their haunted schoolhouse.
Oh, there.
So there you go. It's very close by.
It's so close.
Yep.
That bus that was up there should have been part of it too. Someone needs to tweet at me or something and tell me the scariest thing around here to do, either hayride, maze, hot house, whatever it might be. I want to know the scariest one.
I'm telling you that Sailorsburg Place is best, and then in Jersey, you got to go to the Clinton Mill.
Yeah.
Here we go. We're going to get a little handout here. All right. Thank you. Yes. The Haunted Schoolhouse, it's on 30 East Central Avenue, the East Bangor Fire Company. Fridays and Saturdays till the 28th of this month from 7 to 11, and on Halloween night, 7 to 9. Yeah, that's
good.
Yeah, that's nice.
See, I always like it. You know they're good when they go late, because later you go.
Oh, yeah, look at this.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Look at these masks. Oh.
Oh, boy.
Oh, man. Oh, yeah, he's who I saw who came out
earlier.
That looks like fun.
Check that out.
Thank you. have a fleet of Jeeps coming up.
This is Dada Auto Sales.
And there's a dog. There we go. But the dog's not dressed up at all. So do you dress up your dog for Halloween?
So I bought a costume last year. Obviously, it was a football uniform.
Oh.
Girls wanted to put it on, and he did not care for that very much. So it didn't work out so good, but we tried it.
Now, my friends, a lot of my friends live in New York City. And the big thing, and it's going on this Saturday, I believe, is the Halloween dog parade that they have in Manhattan. And this thing is crazy. I've seen, if you go online and look at the photos, these costumes that people create for their animals are amazing. It's something else. That I think the person to dog ratio is completely off. It's completely off because there's so many people there who want to see these dogs who come by. But that is really fun. My dog this year will be a ladybug.
Oh, all right, that's easy enough.
Yeah,
yes.
So easy. My mom went to like Petco and got the costume, but she got it back in August.
So up at the Country Junction, which is up here on 209 before Lee Heighton, every year they did an animal parade. And one year somebody brought their, I guess it's a small, crocodile, alligator?
No.
A small one, yeah, dressed as is.
Wow.
Yeah, other people have their pets and their dogs, and somebody had a cat. Yeah, alligator.
Who around here that is up for debate.
I did mention it's in Lee Heighton, right? Okay. Yeah, that was something.
That was something else.
Yep.
And that's like something you'd see down in Florida.
Yeah, no ladybug costume on that alligator.
I wonder if at zoos they do something special and dress up some of those animals. I guess those are all wild.
Yeah, they could do that.
Boo at the zoo.
Yeah. Oh, Lehigh Valley Zoo does it, right? Yeah.
Oh.
Up in, that's near New Tripoli, I guess.
Now, that's
the best way to describe
that.
Yeah.
I don't think they have costumes on, but they have some cool leggings on. That's always fun to see.
So this is the Blue, this is Blue Valley Rescue Squad.
A lot louder when you're not in your car and you're listening to it come up behind you and you have to pull over for it. A lot louder.
Good thing a police car wasn't going by and you said pull over for it, because I would have had to ask how many times that's happened for you. Service Electric coming by as well here behind the Blue Valley Rescue Squad.
And we're throwing out candy. Now, who is driving
well,
our car?
Yeah, that's Kim driving
it.
Yeah, she's going to be real happy we identified her there.
Oh, and she's like that house that you want to go to on Halloween because she's just throwing out the candy.
Let's see if she can make it over here. Oh, big handful coming. Oh, boy. I didn't catch any of those.
None of it.
Here we go.
Oh,
I just ran at her feet.
Low.
Here, I'll just grab one here. There we go.
Trucks are coming out this way. Look at that, a personal handing of the candy. That is called customer service.
Yes, absolutely.
Here we go, the fire trucks, Bangor Fire Company up
Santa yet.
No, I don't see one. Be a nice touch, though. Just remember the Macy's parade as a kid. That was, you knew that's when it was over.
Yeah.
Plus, it was like right around noon, and football was coming. But
yep, yep.
Santa was on the fire truck at the end, and you knew, or on his sleigh. You always knew it was going to be, that was going to be just about it.
See, that's why I love Thanksgiving. Yep. You wake up, you've got the parade on, then football. Great meal. Take a little nap in between games. Then you wake up just in time for leftovers.
And more football.
And more football.
Right, yes.
This kind of looks like an old school fire truck, or no?
All painted up in pink.
That's great. October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. I don't know if that was the purpose behind it being painted in pink.
Well, this particular truck's name is Margaret, as we can see on the door and on the front.
Oh, yes, and it's supporting.
Signatures and messages all along the side, yep.
Oh, that's really special. Yep. Lots of messages on that truck. That's great. We always love candy. We're not going to say no to candy.
More Tootsie Rolls coming
Lots
our way.
Lots of Tootsie Rolls. That's like the most popular candy. Huh. But we got the minis and the jumbos. A little bit of everything.
Banger Fire Company with just about every truck they own, I believe, in the parade tonight.
Yeah. Now, it looks like he could be Santa Claus driving.
I was thinking the same thing, yes.
Yeah. So we kind of got our Santa Claus to finish. Oh, now we've got some more. It looks like Double Bubble is coming our way. And if it's a personal delivery, I'm not going to say no to bubble gum.
You got passed up.
I got passed up. I think it was more Tootsie Rolls anyway.
Yeah, focusing on the younger kids too. Let's remember. We got some good stuff over here to hand that one. Oh, no, Megan's going to take it.
I'll take the Reese's. I need that Reese's. I've been eyeing it. You know what? Do you know Warheads?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
We would always do the challenge with you put the black one in because that's the most sour. And you try and not make the squinty face. I never did well with that. Lots of fire trucks. And my older cousin is a firefighter in Jersey City. I should ask him if they do any Halloween parades there. Know though, because I don't think in Jersey City with those streets you're going to want the trucks.
Well, and those guys, I bet, I would imagine they're extremely busy as
well.
Yeah,
they are. Wow, that fire truck gives off heat.
Guys obviously know how to navigate through these streets.
Oh, yeah. Now, no Halloween costumes here.
No,
even though
business.
They don't have to. All business.
Yep, all business.
Because you never know. They might have a call after this.
Yeah.
They're ready to go. Are you a fan at all? Do you watch Chicago Fire? Chicago PD?
I've seen it.
Chicago
Fire,
all
yes.
of them?
they're all in Chicago.
They're all in Chicago.
Everything happens there. I've seen it. Yeah.
I love those TV shows, and I always talk to my cousin about it. He's like, Megan, that is not how real life firefighting works. but I like the drama of it.
Yes. So backdraft wasn't all that accurate, is what you're telling me?
Apparently not.
There we go. Oh, awesome. More lollipops. I dropped them all again.
Oh, man, we have some Reese's and Kit Kats that are on the ground.
Oh, they're on the ground. I gotta be careful when I get up.
Yeah, don't squish my Reese's. You can have one of them. There's two down there. So we can split them evenly. And the Kit Kat, if you want the Kit Kat, we can bring it. The glorious Kit Kat.
I think this is it. This is the final fire truck from the Bangor Fire Department.
And look who's there!
There it is.
Oh, man.
Come on, you had to have known, right?
There we go.
It's your tradition of Santa Claus being on the end, yep.
My night, my first Halloween parade is officially made. We have Santa Claus on the fire truck. This is everything.
Yep.
I got, and Santa waved at me. I feel like a little kid again.
All right, so obviously a very enjoyable night here at the Bangor Parade, brought to you by the Elks, and obviously great atmosphere here, great event too, and the kids got a lot of candy. I think you and I got some too as well, so enjoyable night.
I think we have our fair share to pick apart, and so many fun costumes to see. This was the best first Halloween parade for me to do.
Very enjoyable. Hope you enjoyed it as well, as our Halloween parade coverage continues here on Service Electric. Well, that'll do it for tonight. For our director tonight, Doug Long, and our entire Service Electric TV2 crew, along with Megan Caffrey, I'm Doug Heater, saying so long from Bangor and enjoy the Halloween season.